everybody. Welcome to part two of how to use a stick. Last time I teach you how to do something like this, and today I'm going to teach you how to do this. So basically, last time we teach you all about how to spin a stick. This time we're going to teach you on how to swing that stick around your body like this. I'm not sure if you can see that, so I'm going to get closer. No, you can't see that either. Let me just adjust the camera. Don't complain, people, who's really bad. I just have a little step of creativity. So look, when you do it, you want to catch it. And that's what I do. Look. I'm not doing this where I twist it around my fingers. No, I'm doing it the other way. So let's get back and I'm going to show you one of the tricks before we start. And no, doing this where you put it through your body isn't real. You will have to do it this way. This way. Which is extremely difficult, and we're gonna teach you guys that in part three. But I'm not a professional, as you can see, but yet I can still do this. So basically, what you wanna try to do is you wanna try to move your body up when you spin it and then catch it. It should always move depending on where you throw it. Let's say I throw it over here. You wanna catch it when it goes, and then you let go when it's down, and then you catch it. Something like this type of catch, where it drops and you have to catch it from the air. Those catches are super easy to do sometimes. So sometimes you can really actually do this. You saw? That was a failure, but look. And also, try trying this with your family. It's actually good if you have something that's open as this, as you saw in the last video. Now, another thing you can try to do is you can try doing something I like to throw, the throw-in, which I will show you right about. Wait. So basically, in order to do a throw-in, you have to like throw it and spin it at the exact same time, like this. Oh. I'm not a professional, as I said, so don't complain if it's a bit difficult. But it is a lot more difficult if you try it this way, so I suggest you do it two hands. See, I did it. But it's best if you do it like this, than this, because you have to throw it up. I suggest you just let it drag around your body by force down. Like, if you put it force down on one side, it will go. It's just I'm not so good at it. So, yeah. So, that's one way to do it. Now, another thing is you always want to have a good grip with your stick. If you don't have a good grip, and I shouldn't have teach this on the first episode, but if you don't have a good grip, it can come to some bad issues, like you're not able to spin it as good. Like, you can do this. Wait, it didn't get that on camera. You can do this, and then bow in the face. It's because the grip. As hard as you do it, is how good it will do it. Watch. I did it so hard and such a good grip that it spun all around my wrist, which allowed me to catch it. Bad grip allows it to drop like that. And bad grip is what I usually do sometimes, which is why I'm teaching you guys a lesson. Don't do bad grip. Anyways, another thing you want to try to do is try getting this stick to bounce on your head, like this. Now, in the next video, I'm going to get a smaller stick to show these videos below. The better the bounce, the better it spins. Look at me go. Soda? So yeah, those are also a thing that you can do. Now, if you're trying to do this videos for, now I need to point this out because I need to point this out. So basically, if you're doing these videos to learn how to do something like a dance with a stick like this, that I'm not gonna be able to do because I'm a total failure at dancing. So basically, yeah. These videos aren't for you. I'm sorry, I should have said that in the last video on part one, but I'm not going to. So I'm gonna say it now. So yeah, I hope you guys are doing good with this video, and I hope you guys learned how to do this. Goodbye.